Hello friends, so today we're going to discuss this problem from June Cookoff from CodeChef. Problem first, cache hits. So in this question you are given that chef has a memory machine in which there are two layers. The first layer stores all the information and the next layer stores the cache. So let's assume that the array, the original stored length of the array or the memory is equal to n and the cache length is of the size b. Okay, so caches actually help us to recover or to not recover to access the data efficiently by not just reading every time from the like secondary memory. You can read fast from using the cache. So but cache has a less size in compared to the secondary memory, because secondary memory has a very lot of size, large size. So what they have said that the cache is of size b. So let's assume there. And what they'll do here is we will divide the whole memory, our secondary memory, in blocks. So let's assume you want to access a file whose name is A1. So what they do here is they will do a block or a chunk of secondary memory in, and they call it a block. So all the files from A0 to AB-1, because the size is equal to B, is block 1. Then this is block 2 and so on. Now what we'll do, like if you want to access a file name A1 or like A7, then it might be in the block which is stored in the cache, or it might be not stored in the cache. So if it's stored in the cache, you can directly just take out file from the cache. If it's not stored in the cache, then what you can see here is you have to reload the block from the secondary storage and into the cache. So you have to do some transition. So the thing is, in the like chef has a sequence of elements or like a files he want to access in this order only. Initially the cache is empty. Chef is wondering how many times the machine will need to look up in, like need to load a block in the cache layer, because if this block is not present, if this file block is not present, then the computer or the machine has to load that block in the cache layer. So how many times the cache layer has to load? So let's assume these are the files and the block size is equal to, let's assume, 3. So these 3 is block 1, these 3 is block 2, and because some files are left, but this 3 is block 3. So how, if you want to access a file 0, and this is block 0, let's assume, how we can tell what is the block number? Can we easily tell what is the block number? Yes, just divide it with the block size. So if you want to access the 0th file, just divide it by 3, because the block size is equal to 3, so it's 0. Same, if we divide 1 by 3, it's 0. 2 by 3 is equal to 0. And thus, for this whole block, the block number is 0. Now, if we divide 3 by 3, it's equal to 1. And as you can see, it's block size equal to 1. Block number is equal to 1. 4 divided by 3 is equal to 1. 5 divided by 3 is equal to 1. But 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2. And thus, as you can see, if we just get a file, we can just divide it with the block size. If that block is actually loaded in the cache, then it's fine. Then, or else we have to load this block in the cache. So that's the whole point. I'll take down to the code now. So take the input of n, b, and m. N is the number of elements or the files in the stored secondary memory. B is the block size, and m is the number of like files you want to access. Initially, cache is empty, so initialize it with -1. Then, total is that how many times you have to change the block. Iterate over all the m files, take the input of x, which is the file name. Then what is the block number of that file? It's x divided by b, the block size. Then if cache is not equal to this block, which means that cache doesn't store this block, then what we will do, in that case only, we will make our cache equal to block. It means that we have like take this block, stored it in the cache, and because we have changed, because initially this block was not stored in the cache, we have to do some like transition, and thus total will increase. How many transitions we have done, and for after doing for every file, we will output how many transitions we have done, and that's the total answer. I hope you understand the logic. If you still have any doubts, please mention now. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for more videos. I'll see you in the next one. Keep coding. Bye.